Hello and welcome everyone to Let's Play Tomb Raider 5 Chronicles, Zelgaliz115 speaking, and let me welcome you to the Derelict Chapel where Father Patrick sent us to. And of course, the old bastard is not here. God damn it, Father Patrick. Well, hopefully we'll find out what's holding him up. Now, this is really not about the chapel, it's not gonna make up an entire level. Instead, it's the labyrinth underneath we are interested in. So, in this labyrinth and the surrounding areas, we are gonna find 11 items, we are gonna encounter 6 enemies and actually kill and send off into the afterlife 5 of them in a really cool way, and I'm gonna explain why I'm counting that as a kill a bit later on. We are gonna break no objects, but as for all levels past the sinking submarine, we are gonna find 3 secrets in this short, brief level. The strange thing is, this level might as well not really exist. I mean, the Gallows Tree level flows so well with the third and final Irish level, and this one is just sort of put in between to extend the game artificially, I feel. It really adds nothing to the story, to the narrative, although I have to say, the very beginning of this level, I don't know, it's so atmospheric and magnificent. Anyway, I'm gonna explain what I mean. First of all, our objective is to slide into the actual labyrinth via a ramp behind this locked crate. To open it up, we need to perform a ritual which will also dispatch 5 particularly annoying enemies, but not yet, the place is completely empty. However, if you don't know what to do, you know what, let's get a hint from a creepy but kindly spirit. I mean, it is a hint. We do need to get behind this grate and interact with whatever on earth that thing was, but I mean, how on earth are we gonna do that? We are corporeal, so we cannot just pass through this grate, we need to unlock it first. Again, no explanation as to who or what that spirit is, other than looking absolutely terrifying, but he does remind me of Brother Obscura from Angel of Darkness. Pretty much the worst boss fight in the Tomb Raider history. Yeah, so I'm gonna refer to him as Brother Obscura from now on. Now, Brother Obscura means well, he's only gonna show up in 2 cutscenes, one of them we just saw, and give us a hint in each. So, in order to get where he could, since we are corporeal and cannot just face through, we need to unlock it via solving a puzzle. What we see ahead of us are 3 pushable tiles. I have no idea what they represent. This means absolutely nothing to me, seems to be some Celtic motif. Then what seems to be a bird or an animal, and then the face of a man or maybe God. I mean, in Christian beliefs, they look one and the same. I would assume these are more pagan symbols, so I'm just gonna assume that's a human, right? So it's interesting because I solved this puzzle on my very first try, thinking back to the Lost City of Tinos in Tomb Raider 3, where there was a hierarchy of I think plants, animals, and humans. Here it's something similar. I don't know what the first pattern means. It could be interpreted as grass, plants, vines, something like that. I don't know. But the second thing should be an animal, and the third a human, according to some kind of hierarchy out there. So let's press them in that order. If you do press them in any other order, don't worry. It's not going to be like underneath the Sphinx where you're going to get punished and sent into a trap corridor. They're just going to reset until you figure it out. So for many people, it's also trial and error. But I was so happy when my first one worked. I actually thought maybe I chose the incorrect one and I'm getting punished via the following cutscene. But no, observe. Did you notice that the old benches were moving? That is terrifying. We are not alone here, and there is an invisible force here with us. Or semi-visible. Now, by the way, if you do press them again in this same order, you will end up locking the grate that we just opened, so there really is no point. But just as an interesting side note, you can do that. Here we have, oh my god, 5 floating Spooky Scary Skeletons. Yes, that's it. Roll the song.
Spooky Scary Skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight.
No, really. These guys are basically the enemies that we are going to dispatch, and I'm going to count as kills via performing a ritual in this very cauldron. It's going to be a funny cutscene. I have no idea who these are. I guess some fallen warriors who are protecting the tomb we just unlocked, and they're assuming we are there to raid it. I mean, we are the Tomb Raider. But actually, we are not. Well, not entirely. It does contain the first secret of the level. So, what we need to do is make our way across and try and not get hit. If you do get hit once or twice, it's fine, but I think it's 4 or 5 strikes of their massive swords, and Lara is dead, and I don't want to see her again after the gallows tree. So, the closer you get to them, the more they... See? Oh, materialized. That was very quick. Now, one of really cool ways to bypass the swipes is to do a somersault like that. That also helps. But instead, how about I show you a completely safe path through them? So, once in the middle, to show us that they exist, this guy is blocking the left path, so let's go via the right one. There are 5 overall in this chapel, and the benches have moved, which actually helps us out a lot. That's very kind. There's one put right here in the middle, but you can squeeze in between this column and the bench and continue. And yet now we're surrounded by 2. We don't need to go there. We actually need to go through to here. But if you're fast enough, see? He's not even going to try and swing that sword, so it's not really a big problem. The problem is playing, again, the PS1 version and not seeing a bloody thing. So, first of all, we are at the warrior's tomb underneath. Okay, we are tomb raiding. I see why those warriors wanted to protect it. We get a small health pack for whatever reason. We cannot interact with this warrior in any shape or form. It doesn't seem to have any significance for Lara. There are banners which remind me of the Lost Library of Alexandria, but I cannot make out the motifs on them. I don't have binocs or flares to light it up. Also, being dynamic objects, I don't think lightning from binoculars would work on them. Anyway, what we are interested in, as completionists, is the secret behind this grate. I'm going to show you how to open it. But what Lara is particularly interested in is following the trail of the ghostly spirit, who did something with whatever the hell this gem on the bench is. Okay, that was an incredibly creepy and terrifying tune. I never want to hear that again. Funnily enough, for those of you who are maybe familiar with the PS1 version, if you go into the pause screen and press options and start setting the music volume, this is the same melody you will hear as a music sample to allow you to test how high your volume is. It is incredibly annoying if you're playing around with the options in-game and you hear this tune over and over and over. It's like something from a small church... windpipes? I don't know exactly what that melody is, but it terrified me to no end, and it started playing until Lara put it back. And inside is a bone dust? I mean, whose bones are we talking about? That's what I want to know. Like, I know especially Christian believers keep all sorts of relics who are basically just bone fragments or bone dusts of so-called holy people, and for some reason that's considered interesting. Maybe it's something like that, so... this chapel used to be Christian and now it became desecrated and inhabited by spooky scary skeletons. I don't know what happened. But anyway, we have a bone dust, as the spirit has shown us. I'm not sure if maybe the bone dust belongs to that Brother Obscura guy. I truly have no idea. It's not explained anywhere. And you know what? Sometimes that's fine. Makes for things to be way more mysterious. But we need to make our way back through the skeletons. Or maybe let's somersault our way. So stylish, Lara. Oh, I love this move so much, I can't get enough of it. Okay, let's squeeze in behind this column and the wall, and we should be safe like this. And if you approach this cauldron, you get to actually interact with it. We get to kill all 5 of these skeletons and unlock the grate opposite the one where we just entered. So let's observe what happens. Now Lara puts it in, it starts burning immediately, and once it burns out, the following will happen. And it seems the party is over. So just like that. Yes, I maybe you will not agree with me, and that's fine. Let me know in the comments, but I am considering this a kill. This was a camera flyby, and we've basically just removed enemies which had permanence via very unusual and crafty means. I like this. Pistols don't solve all our problems. Ah, so long, spooky, scary skeletons. I'm gonna miss you. Now, the grate over here open, we can slide down the ramp and continue, but you would miss out on a lever which actually opens the final grate in the warrior's tomb, behind which is the first secret. So, let's continue and sprint all the way across, and this will basically be our farewell with this chapel. There's nothing else here for us. Ah, interesting, these are actually smaller benches than in the main room, because we can jump over these. We cannot jump over those in the main room, I guess, just to make avoiding skeletons more interesting. And what's awesome is that not only is this a wall niche, like the open mouth in the Streets of Rome level, but also it comes with an actual pickup, a reward for finding a secret. That this is revolutionary, seriously. And of course it's not a box of flares, it's yet another health pack. Not like we are gonna use them in Ireland. But you know what, don't wanna jinx it. Maybe we are gonna use a health pack in the final level of Ireland, we'll see. Now over here I recommend making it into that hole immediately and avoid taking damage from the bats. Oh my god! Yeah. Whoa, what was that? I tried to make a somersault and Lara... Wow, that was interesting. Okay, that was actually pretty damn cool, Lara. I don't know how you pulled that off. Yeah, so swarm of bats. Now, normally I'd recommend you get into that hole immediately, but I first wanted to stop here and show you what is it we're after. Right behind these wooden panels where Lara you could totally squeeze in, please stop pretending, okay? I know you're very self-conscious of your body, like all girls at your age are, but come on, you can fit in, you can squeeze in, but you just want to play by the rules, you want to explore this place, don't pretend you don't. So inside one of the Iron Maidens is the level exit, in front of it is the large health pack. To do that, we'll need to pass a very interesting chamber consisting of essentially five towers and a labyrinth with a beast inside, which I think is such a cool concept. Anyway, unfortunately results in a fairly forgettable level. Let's go into this toxic green goo. Okay, I was not aware that Lara's falling scream when she's young is the same sound but with higher pitch. Uh-oh. Okay, thank you again, Brother Obscura. So, you know what? Just like before, this was a hint. If we follow him, we're gonna be just fine. Now, there is a problem with that. Just like before, we are not a ghost that can float around. We actually need to create a physical path for us to continue. Now, a couple of things. In that cutscene, feel free to even rewind it and rewatch it, Brother Obscura exited a chamber marked with this very symbol where we're in, and that is a, I guess, a horned devil or something along those lines, or some people call it a man wearing a helmet with horns. Up to your interpretation, really. And he entered into a chamber marked with a three-faced head. Now that could either be the Roman god Janus, or what I think is way more likely, maybe the idol worshipped by people in other parts of the world called Baphomet. It's actually something that's been explored in the Broken Sword games that I made also quiet walkthroughs for. Feel free to check those out. But apparently it seems to be an idol also worshipped by some of the Knights Templar. It's never been a confirmed rumor, but that's what I'm going to refer to it as, Baphomet, when we see it. First of all, yeah, you know what? Let me explain something, and let's get in here for me to be able to show you. First of all, a small health pack on our way here. And this right here is where Brother Obscura exited from and entered. Well, not entirely, because he was a couple of floors above us. Let me explain. It's easier than it sounds. So what we are is a tower with three huge rotating gears. Underneath of us is a pool of lava. Above us are two more stories of rotating gears, and we just need to make our way to the top third one, rotate it, and enter a chamber marked, again, I wish I could use binocs to show you, with a three-faced head, so Janus or Baphomet. To do that, we only need to press one lever. That's right ahead of us. That's it. And not follow what the cutscenes show us, because they are completely misleading. My god, I'm actually just angry thinking about this. Anyway, surrounding the three gears are four towers, just like the one where we are right now, each bearing its symbol. Right now it's the devil symbol or the horned helmet. And from each of these four towers, you can enter three different levels of the spinning gears room. See, we are now at the second level. Maybe, unless you are colorblind, try to remember them via their colors. The bottom one was red with a pool of lava. This one is more purple or blue, and it has these holes in the floor. If you do fall down there, jets of flame will start spitting, okay? Similar like the pressure cookers in the submarine level. So again, Lara will be set on fire. If we go via additional floor up, we're gonna find ourselves in the third and top spinning gear room that's gonna have a green color to it, okay? I think the rooms would look a bit different with volumetric fog enabled, but you know what? There is an easy way to test that thanks to Tomb 5 patch. So, fog. Let's see fog. Well, that... that is disappointing. You know what? I'm gonna try it one more time when we get to the mid level. Okay, so Breath of Obscura basically exited this with the horned helmet or the devil and entered the Baphomet room. That's actually where we need to go to continue, and the door will open as soon as we pick up a very important key item, okay? So that's it. And each of these is surrounded by four towers, like the one with the horned devil helmet, where we emerge from. And in those towers can be a couple of goodies or even the second secret. But it's worthwhile, I think, to check all four towers from up to bottom to scan anything thoroughly. So yeah, we are here at the very top. We cannot get any higher, unfortunately, because it's broken off. So, in order to make any real progress, and I really hope this is not confusing and that this makes sense, again, I could just show you exactly what to do and reach the exit, but then you would have no understanding or maybe even appreciation for the level design. Yeah. So this is the sickly green goo we emerged from when we fell from the top, hearing Lara scream, if that's even possible, in an even higher pitched noise. Before we do anything and rotate any of these mechanisms, let's make a note of the broken off railing. This is a secret I actually found out about very easily. I thought, okay, broken off rail means that we need to get there. And I thought it's actually going to be a way to continue the level, and then I just realized, hold on a sec, this only leads us to a dead end with the second secret golden rose. Okay. Now, this jump is a bit tricky. You need to make a running jump. Why not a swan dive? Because of the roof here. And make sure you do it from the left part of that square, enabling Lara the most generous altitude. Anyway, we are entering the bottom part of the Baphomet Tower, but it's completely caved in. It's a dead end. But at least we get our hands on the second secret rose. Yay! No. Yes, Lara, that is the second secret golden rose. Now, to do it back, it's the same ordeal as before, right? Just make a running jump, corner shimmy, climb up, and basically do exactly the same jump as before onto the broken off railing part. But it is the top floor of the Baphomet Tower we need to reach. Yeah, at least the bottom one has a secret with us, even though without a reward, but I know it would just be a health pack, so who cares. Okay, mind you, do not make a forward jump and touch whatever this ledge above is. It tends to push Lara down into the pool of lava. Just, I get to test all sorts of crazy stuff when I'm not recording. Okay, now I want to show you something absolutely infuriating. This maze is kind of easy to figure out because we've reached the dead end with a single mechanism. But I want to show you something really, 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 really important. This right here, where it is attached to, is the devil face. We're gonna turn it by 90 degrees and attach it to the picture displaying two men fighting. Now observe very closely the symbols in this cutscene. So it already seems to have been attached to the two men fighting, and now it got attached to a person carrying a spear and a shield, okay? Let's forget about the green room. Let's just focus on the red one. Okay, do you see what it is attached to? It moved from the horned helmet to the two men fighting, but the cutscene showed us it moving from the two men fighting over to the spear and shield carrier. Why? Basically, the devs messed up the cutscene, that's why. You can also press the lever again. And this time, it will show us the correct version of it moving from the two fighting men back to the horned helmet. But basically, because of some oversight or complete lack and disregard for quality control and, let's be honest, very tight schedule to finish this game, the cutscene completely misleads you, which is unforgivable. But basically, it only moves in one direction by 90 degrees, and when you press it again, it moves again in that direction, right? Now it's in fact moving from the horned helmet to the two men fighting, not from the two men fighting to the spear carrier, but yeah. Let's just ignore that cutscene. And you know what? I'm gonna check if the second cutscene, when we are gonna be moving the second lever, is gonna be also correct or incorrect. So hopefully this was not confusing. You just need to press it once, and actually there's gonna be another lever and you don't need to press that one at all. But anyway, we explored the horned helmet tower thoroughly. We are now gonna explore the two men fighting tower. And let's try and first make it to the very bottom. Oh, we already have. Okay, that's straightforward enough. So nowhere else to go but up from here. Now, we can go to the mid-level, or we can go to the very top level. But let's see if there is maybe some goodie or pickup at the very top. No, just a dead end again. And actually, trying to access the top gears room is also going to result in a dead end. See? These are just not aligned, because by turning the very first lever, we also turned the one over here. Okay, so, but we had no other way to continue in the first place, so it's not like we messed up or anything. We just need to go to the mid-level first, from the two-man fighting tower. My god, these sentences I'm constructing make no sense because of these symbols. Okay. Onward and onward. And there we go, with an access to the middle gears room, the blue one, which no cutscene has shown us now. Now this one seems to be attached to the two men fighting, and by rotating it to 90 degrees we should move it to a spear and a shield carrier. Again, let's see what it will show us. Oh no, it already is attached to both! Ah, yeah, that's right, we can just ignore the lever. No, I'm still curious to see what the cutscene will show us. So it's two men fighting, spear and shield guy, and if we turn it, it moves from two men fighting, and I assume spear and shield guy, to the horned helmet. Is that correct? Okay, two men fighting and a horned helmet. Okay, so this cutscene was in fact correct. Now we've already explored the horned helmet tower, right? We are gonna find ourselves at the mid-level. We've already been here. Nothing else for us to see, right? I just want to show you how it all connects together. Now let's just move this lever back, because we already explored the horned devil tower. And we just emerge from the two-man fighting tower, which we also explored thoroughly, so there is actually no point in turning this. But I want to see if the cutscenes are at least correct. Okay, yeah, this one works. Okay, so only the first one seems to have been messed up. Okay, so we came from the two-man fighting tower. Let's get into the next one, the new one, the spear carrier. We are at a mid-level, so let's first explore this all the way down. Yeah, nothing for us at the very bottom, and I think we should find the bottom gears room now inaccessible. Is that correct? Yep, that is correct. And we emerged from the mid-level, so really the only point right now is to get to the very top, and if I'm not mistaken, the very top of the spear carrier tower will also have a small health pack for us. Finally, something for that confusing exploration. Ah, there it is. Awesome. Okay, Miss Croft, please pick it up. Thank you so much. Okay, Lara, you're not helping particularly. Please stand up. Thank you. Okay, and the Top Gear's room, I think this is the first time we find ourselves in the green one. Okay, the music is a very good sign. And there is no lever, so we cannot even rotate this structure on this level. Remember, when we pressed the first lever, it actually moved the top gear room, the green one, and also the bottom red one. And then the one on the second level, in the blue, only moved the blue. So there actually doesn't need to be a third lever, right? And that doesn't need to be even the second lever, because you don't need to press it to continue, as we established. Anyway, we are finally here where Brother Obscura passed by, and the moment we pick up the book, The door over there opens, which is just awesome. Now, the book itself is rather interesting. It's a bestiary, and it doesn't really play any role in this level, but it absolutely will play a key part in the next one. Things would take a very sour turn for Lara and Father Patrick Dunstan in case she would not find it. Anyway, so let me know in the comments, please, just how confusing this was, but all you need to do is press the first lever in the lava room and then make it all the way to the top, ignore the second lever, and you'll basically find the bestiary at the top. It's a strange concept. I feel like there's more that could have been done. And what makes it worse is that the very first cutscene simply lies to you with the symbol display. So, yeah, not happy about that. I'm actually quite irritated and angry if you cannot trust the game's own cutscenes. Now, remember, the bottom part of the Baphomet Tower was actually caved in where we found the second rose. So we are not gonna find any way down, but there is a large health pack at least as a consolation prize, not that we'll need it, and there is some kind of Will-O-The-Wisp. Now the cool thing is, and you know what, I actually appreciate the fact that we do not have flares or binocs right now, because this thing illuminates the path. Not only it shows us where to go, but has a genuine light-up effect, which I think is fairly neat. Okay. But we don't want to follow it in its entirety because we want to get our hands on the third and final secret, and oh my god, this is monkey swingable. It's the same texture that was used over the spiky pit in the gallows tree, but no, that was not monkey swingable, and young Lara paid the price for that, gosh darn it. Okay, now some corner shimmying above a spike pit will take us to that rose. Again, I feel like it's kind of difficult to miss, it's a very easy secret to find. I think the first one was actually the trickiest, you know, to see that there is a lever and you need to jump up high at the end of the tunnel. Again, I don't think many people would notice that, but the second and third are fairly easy. Okay, and let me quickly check. We have 3 out of 3 and 24 out of 36. We still haven't unlocked anything new, but that's fine. We're gonna do so when we wrap up Ireland. I mean, at least I hope so. I haven't actually tested yet. Oh, we'll see. I think we're in for a pleasant surprise, not a nasty one. Okay, and here let's just do a somersault forward, move forward and jump out and repeat this process. Easy as that. Whoa, whoa, okay. Well, maybe not quite as easy. Oh, Lara, please do not embarrass me. I mean, I'm embarrassing myself, it's not really your fault, but you're a scapegoat. Okay, and now, instead of monkey swinging, let's just grab the ledge over there. The light is getting impatient. Whoa. Talk about impatient, it disappeared on us. What the hell? Was that supposed to happen? Anyway. Oh, by the way, I'm not considering the light an enemy or anything like that. I don't know what it is. It's a flowing particle effect. Surely you'll forgive me that it's not an enemy that I'm counting. Oh, I hear it. I think it just skipped ahead. Okay, let's follow this corridor. And we find ourselves in a labyrinth chased by a beast. Okay, the moment we make another step, you know what, it's better to show rather than tell. There it is, Amit the Devourer, smaller version that looks like a rabbit rat combined with a werewolf. Yeah, but this is Amit from Tomb Raider 4, just retextured, and it's out to get us in what I think is actually officially the labyrinth part of the level. Let me explain. There are gonna be a couple of holes over which we can jump, okay? They are all gonna lead into this very corridor, so let me show it to you in its entirety. This has many, many holes adjacent to it. Whenever you'll see torches and side corridors like that, this signifies a hole. We can basically jump over these holes or just walk around them and try not to get completely gobbled up by whatever that beast is. None of the walkthroughs I have checked online or any of the fan sites have really called it, as far as I'm aware. Guys, in case you know some trivia about this monster, please let me know, but I'm just gonna refer to it as a labyrinth beast. So, it's out to get us. Now, unlike Lara, it cannot jump over the pits, which is why these, oh my god, corridors exist. Ah, oh, damn it. Okay, so these are the kinds of corridors that the labyrinth beast can take to reach us, even though it cannot jump, okay? Now, if you just follow the light and do nothing else, you'll be fine, but I don't know, I want to show you the side corridors as well, just to make more sense of the layout. And sometimes they will actually lead to dead ends, which, as you can imagine, is, oh my god, dangerous. Ah, why am I doing this? Why can't I just follow the light? Again, I have to say I appreciate the fact that in this particular situation we do not have flares. Fine, okay, I concede. Because the guiding light offers so much more value like this. And this should be another dead end. Wonderful. And the beast should be... Oh, okay, it's taking its sweet time. Good news for us. Again, all these side corridors around the pits are really just there so the beast can get you, because it cannot jump. And we've reached the end. And actually, observe something strange. When sliding down... Oh, farewell light, or will-o'-the-wisp. When sliding down, Lara will actually teleport to a different part of the level. This is really odd, to say the least. See, the camera just jerks, and all of a sudden we are somewhere else completely. And I think if we had binocs, we would see that that sliding slope is actually a dead end on both sides. I'm pretty sure we were just teleported somewhere else. I cannot even hear the beast moving around anymore. So I think that's what happened. They just used a trick. And over here, our reward is a large health pack. Ah, I mean, we got what, bit or clawed twice by that beast, and we are at half our health, so... Yeah, I mean, I get it. That's fair enough. Now, this should look familiar. We've been on the other side, just as we exited the chapel and entered the whole labyrinthine structure. So, as I said, it's all about getting past these wooden boards, I guess. Now, before we make another step and pass through the Iron Maiden, which has the same shape as the sarcophagi in Tomb Raider 4, let me show you the statistics screen. So, my friends, this was the labyrinth. Again, I feel like a completely unnecessary level in between the gallows tree and the old mill, but at least we got our hands on a bestiary, and that's definitely gonna come in handy. We have found all 11 items. We have actually dispatched 5 of 6 enemies. There is no way to get rid of the labyrinth beast. And we have found all 3 secrets, but unfortunately didn't break any objects, which is always a shame in my humble opinion. I'm obsessed by those things. Now you can see the time taken, the distance traveled over on the right side, and of course we have fired no shots. And what I'm happy about, we have not used any health packs either. So, I'm very happy to make a save here, and I will see you guys next time in the Old Mill.
Good Lord, girl, it's me. I've enough on my plate without you making me jump out of my skin and all.
Your hair.
What about me hair?
It's white.
That'd be right. I was detained by some unpleasant fellas from down below. Gave me quite a fright. That's why I wasn't at the chapel. But I can see you've kept yourself busy. Anyways, let's get you out of here and back to safety.